Volta, and Volta arrived here at the Alaska Raptor Center in 1992 after colliding with a power line here on the Sitka waterfront. That collision led to electrocution injuries, a concussion, as well as multiple fractures throughout his body. So we were able to rehabilitate a lot of those issues, but one bone never fully healed correctly, and that's in a bone called the coracoid. And that's up in the rotational area of his shoulder, and it's critical for him to gain lift and to help get him off the ground. So he was deemed unreleasable because, as you can imagine, it's pretty important to get fish up out of the water once you actually catch them in your talons. But he quickly became a superstar around here. He's visited over 15,000 school children across the lower 48 and here in Alaska. They're in classroom visits and them coming to visit us. He's gone on cruise ships and shown his adaptability in the tight hallways in there and done shows. He's the only animal to be featured on A Question in Jeopardy twice, so his picture showed up on TV a couple times. He's a little stuck there. And he even went to New York, and he rang the stock exchange bell. So he's done a little bit of everything, and he's well-traveled. But if you guys had any questions, I would be more than happy to answer those for you.
How long did the eagles live in captivity?
In captivity. So in captivity, he's going to get fed every day. He's going to get vitamins and calcium every other day. So he can live upwards of 50 years old here in captivity. Out in the wild, bald eagles, at the best of times, can live up to 35 years old. Oh, he was just flying, and he wasn't being too graceful at that time, or he wasn't too smooth when he was flying, so he ended up just accidentally hitting the power line instead of getting around it. Yeah, just an accident.
How long did it take you guys to find him after he hit?
Well, they found him pretty quickly, so within a day or two they found him, and he was hurting pretty bad and a little emaciated, and then somebody gave us a call from in town, and we were able to go and pick him up and rescue him. We'll put on leather coats and leather gloves, and we'll bring blankets and nets to try to go capture him, and it becomes a big old wrangling process.
How old is he now?
So age. He's going to be turning 28 for us this year. He arrived to us as a full-grown adult, so that means he has the full white head, the white tail, and the yellow beak. And that takes 5 years to get that full adult plumage. So when they arrive to us as adults, we don't know how long they've been adults for out in the wild. So we just start counting from five. So he can be anywhere from 28 or older for us. Nope, he doesn't want that piece.
It's amazing how he can eat the leaf and pick the skin off.
Yeah, he gets fed every day, so he can get pretty picky about his food. So a lot of times he'll just end up taking the meat off the skin and just leaving the skin for me to deal with.
Can they reproduce here in the...
We don't do any reproduction here in the center. Bald eagles, generally, when they reproduce in captivity, it has to be through artificial insemination. So we don't have the permits or the equipment for that. Those are both very expensive. A reason that they're artificially inseminated in captivity is a big part of bald eagle mating is they have an elaborate ritual where they'll fly into the air and they'll lock talons and they'll spiral towards the ground. And they'll split before they hit the ground. And that's to test the strength and the aptitude of that partner. And if they're unable to test their partner, then they're most likely not going to pick a partner in captivity. This is getting messy today. Oh, yeah, little girl there.
Why aren't his eyes completely yellow?
His eyes are an ice-ish, bluish green color. So when they're babies, they'll actually be brown, so their eyes will be brown colored, and then over the 5 years when they're turning into adults and when they get their white head and their yellow beak and their white tail, their eyes will slowly turn this ice blue, ice green color from brown, actually. So yellow is kind of a color we don't normally see. A lot of people like to draw them with yellow eyes because it makes them look cool.
We have time for one more question.
I saw a hand up right over.
Are bald eagles in the wild only riparian feeders?
They'll hunt for their food, but they're also big carrion feeders. They will hunt, but they're also not afraid to scavenge for food. It's a lot easier to find dead food and to eat that than it is to catch food up out of the water and to catch your own prey. They're also big into stealing food from smaller birds. So if another bird has caught food, it's a lot easier to take it from them and scare them and get the food than it is to capture it yourself. So these guys are big opportunistic hunters, and they're more than willing to eat dead things or things that they didn't catch themselves.
Now, Robert will be right back out to answer any more questions that you may have, but now it's time for Volta to return to his habitat now. If you all please just remain seated and hold your applause.
right, thank you guys for showing up here today. It's because of folks like yourself that I get to do the job that I do up here, and birds like Volta get to come out on the stage and educate new folks. So we encourage you to check out our Yelp and our TripAdvisor. We also have a very cool Facebook page under the Alaska Raptor Center that documents all the birds we get here on a daily basis, and we'll have photos and updates on them from when they come into the door and hopefully get released back out into the wild. So thanks again, you guys, for showing up here today.